Last week, we had a little bit of trouble loading logs. More than one viewer suggested that I put a winch on the trailer. That seemed like a very good idea after that day, so I did. 3,500-pound winch for only $50 or so. It was time to try out my new skill of welding. Now, when I say new skill, I welded exactly once, just fastening two pieces of steel together. This would be the first time I would weld a real project. Well, this is obviously not some skill you just read about and do it. Those are some mighty ugly welds. I had a little bit of trouble, mostly because I was not in a comfortable position with my hands and arms rested. But after a few false starts, I managed to get a few fairly decent welds, although they are ugly. I decided to notch the board to make it fit more snugly. It was only a stroke of luck that the mounting holes for the winch all went through wood and steel. I backed the winch up far enough I had plenty of knuckle clearance at the trailer. What I did not allow for was clearance on that angle brace. I had to put the winch handle in a vise and rearrange the bends to give it clearance. Again, I used my 2x12 ATV ramps for the log ramps, this time with the cleat side down. That left a small problem, the cleat at the end that holds it on the bed of the pickup truck or the trailer while I'm loading is sticking up, making it difficult to get logs started. I used two bar clamps to hold the boards together to make a wider ramp. So far, so good. Boat winches I'm familiar with have two positions for the ratchet, pre-spooling and locking. This one has ratchets going and coming with a free-spool position in between. However, there's no detent to hold it in the free-spooling position. I'll have to modify this winch to fix that. The new cable is like a spring, and when released, it snarls into a bird's nest on the spool. One solution is to have your partner put tension on the cable while you unwind it. That way I could hold the pawl in the free spool position. The first log is small enough that it was easy to maneuver onto the bottom of the ramp. Once the top end of the log is in the trailer, it probably doesn't matter whether the rest of the log stays on the ramp or not.
You might need to push that with your foot or something. It wants to slide out.
I asked Narada to hold the cable and explain that with no tension, it snarls like a fishing reel. Now comes the first real test of our winch and loading system. This is one of the largest logs we'll pull out of this marsh. I need a little more cable. Narada gets her first turn at the winch. You doing okay? We'll push up more. On the tool. Let me
adjust it.
It's almost ready to go up into the trim.
If we ever need more cranking power, the crank handle will attach at the shaft on the rear of the winch with much lower gearing. So far, we haven't needed to use it. I'll put a link to the winch in the description, if I remember. Like this to pull it out. Okay, cool. This will be easier. It's little. The cable is breaking in nicely and is no longer quick to snarl when tension is released. Lifting or rolling heavy logs onto the ATV ramps is difficult. I'll have to make a better ramp.
Okay, just hold this like this. Wants to come up. This is a crank it a little bit. You can take it off. There you go.
The cable will not wind level except on a nearly perfectly straight pull. I see a modification in my future. Two modifications. Once again, two people make a job easier than doing it alone. Maybe we can make this go faster, at least with small logs, by dragging up two at a time.
Boy, this thing's loud.
finished what I need to do.
We've loaded all the wood we had piled up, and there's still room in the trailer, so now I'll try to get in this log that I couldn't drag up last time because I forgot the cant hook, and I couldn't roll the log to get a chain or a cable under it. Backing the ATV into the marsh was easy. Dragging this log out between the stumps might not be so easy. Strike one. Strike two. Strike two and a half. Home run. This is the second biggest log of the day. I need to make more room in the trailer. I dragged the log too close to the trailer, and now getting it up onto the ramp is a problem.
Oh, will you get me that piece of wood? Right over there.
Huh.
Once again, teamwork gets the job done.
The other ones were down here, I think.
Yeah. Oops, forgot about the camera.
Okay, are you still on?
My wife is getting pretty good at this, and what's more important, she enjoys it. Well, after all this, I was very pleased that all 9 of my amateurish wells held up. It was time to get ready to go home. Too much stuff, too little space. Lucky for me, most of the weight in this machine is in the front. Piece of pie, easy as cake. This July has been a little like living in Arizona. No precipitation. You can leave everything out overnight.